campus of the University of North Carolina in Chapel Hill. Keenan Stadium is the venue for today's game. And now it's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. North Carolina has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. Virginia Tech's offense really centered around this quarterback, and as he goes, the team seems to go, Kirk.
Brett, over the weeks, I've been watching him on film, and one thing I've seen is his ability to make good decisions. I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And when you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense, you're going to move the football down the field.
And he's tackled around the 34-yard line.
You've got to play with that kind of purpose to move the ball against this defense.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 34-yard line. Tackle made right around the 34. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. He's got it out to his tight end, and he's taken down at about the 39-yard line.
That'll make it 35.
From their own 39-yard line, it's third down. And a quick throw. Tackle right around the 48-yard line.
There you go. Good read by the quarterback to give the offense a new set of downs. If the defense wants to line up and man, work that slant route until they stop it.
Scrambling around. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. They'll bring him down at the 36.
They've obviously found a formula for moving the ball against this defense. Let's see if any adjustments are made before their backs are really against the wall.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 36. He scrambles. They'll make the sack.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
Defense looking for another sack here on this second and 13 situation. Tosses out to the tailback on the screen, and down he goes at the 40-yard line. So it's another third down upcoming here. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
Virginia Tech could take the lead with this field goal. It's up. And he just drilled it from long range. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. Big opening. He's taken down at about the 37-yard line. lines up in the pocket. Quick pass. Brought down around the 44-yard line. And he has it on the corner. He's tackled around the 46-yard line. And they make the stop around the 42-yard line. Second and 15. Ball on the 47-yard line. Throws it in a hurry. And he's tackled around the 38-yard line. Slings it. And he tackles him hard at the 34-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. And he hits him hard at the 29. Short over the middle. Tackle made around the 25-yard line.
Number 66 makes the tackle. That brings him 75.
Check, check. Line 80. Tiger. Line. Tiger.
They get to the quarterback, and now the ball is loose. That's a great tackle at the 32-yard line. Here's the 12th play of the drive.
Three down, Mike 36.
Set, 319, check, check.
Motion.
200, check.
Throws this one out to the left. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch. An exciting first quarter comes to an end. 3-0, Virginia Tech. Set to resume action here in the second quarter, and we've got a tight ball game.
Watch 36. 36 to Mike.
Set. Green 90. Green.
Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. Touchdown, Tar Heels. Splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 13-play, 76-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
An amazing drive for this offense. Outstanding execution. If you're the defense, you've got to do something to try to change things up to get this quarterback out of sync.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Motion.
makes it to the 37. From their own 37-yard line, it's first down. He's at midfield. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
Very well-designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely, and it went for a good gain.
For the tight end, but they can't hook up.
Sure, it's disappointing, but this is the kind of mechanical flaw you can fix with practice and coaching.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 47. Catches it, and he's looking for more. And he's taken down around the 34-yard line.
The middle linebacker came on a blitz, which can be very disruptive. Sometimes a quarterback will get happy feet when they see that coming. But not this guy. He's very composed and can deliver under a pass rush.
He's at the 20. Inside the 10. Touchdown, Hokies.
Did you see how explosive he looked? He had his sights set on the end zone, and he was not going to be stopped.
Trying to go up by three, they'll kick the extra point. And he hits the PAT. A five-play, 75-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So the score now, 10-7. Taken at the five. He's pushed out of bounds at the 43-yard line.
Brad, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Got it and brought down immediately. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. He makes the catch and has a first down. They'll spread the field with five wide. Just throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Caught with room to work. And he is drilled at the 17. It out to about the 14-yard line. Big play there, and now they're looking at first and goal. At the 2-yard line. He gets
gets rid of this one.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Touchdown, North Carolina. The extra point. A nice 10-play, 43-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The score now, 14-10. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 24.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Defense looking for another sack in the second down and long situation. In the shotgun and five wideouts. Fires out to his receiver. Tackled at about the 29-yard line.
Number 55 with the tackle at the 29-yard line. That'll make it 35.
He tries to buy some time. They'll bring him down right around the 36-yard line. First and 10. Ball on their own 36. And down he goes at about the 41.
I'll tell you something. I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
From the 41-yard line, first down. Receiver and he can't make the grab. Caught and big hit there to stop it. Nothing going on that play.
Well, here I think the quarterback needs to be a little bit more patient in the pocket. That way he can allow his receivers to get downfield a little bit before he throws them.
He flings it left. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
That makes it first and 10.
Man left, man left.
From the 17-yard line. First down. He makes it to the 15-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback.
This linebacker's had a couple years of experience, and he's really solidified himself as a reliable tackler, as you can see from that last stop.
And he throws it away. They've been 2 for 2 on third downs in this drive, and they'll try to convert again here.
Oh,
open field. What a play, and that is first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
He's going to try and scramble. And he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a three-point lead with this extra point. And he tacks on the extra point. It was an 11-play, 77-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown. So our score, 17-14. They line up to kick this one away. From his own goal line. And down he goes at the 23-yard line. The Tar Heels' slow start really didn't bring them down at all. Look where they are now.
Well, their offense has caught fire here in the second quarter, and now all of a sudden they're back in a position to be competitive in this game. And who knows, maybe they can take the lead before we get to the half.
The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Quick throw to the tight end. He's taken down right around the 34. From their own 34-yard line. It's first down.
Let's go. Green and he ain't hot.
Hauls it in as he's pushed out of bounds. First and 10. Ball on the 49. Got it on the quick throw. Brought down at about the 43-yard line. The Tar Heels are going to call their second timeout.
Three down.
So we'll probably get one last heave to the end zone here before halftime. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. A great first half comes to a close. The Hokies with a three-point lead.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation, then excitement. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. We've been looking forward to this game all week, and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
But you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
We've done what we can do here at halftime. Time to get you back out to the second half. We'll keep an eye on everything going on in college football. Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit ready with a call.
Boy, I hope the second half's as good as the first. Just about set to start the third quarter in a tight one. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Throws it deep. Picked off by the senior. And they make the stop at the 44-yard line. He didn't throw it away under pressure, and it really cost him.
It sure did. He saw that he was going to get hit and just threw one up for grabs. He's got to learn to take the sack.
From the 44-yard line, first down. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Number 18, the intended receiver. That makes it second and 10.
Virginia Tech is up a field goal. down, and he's out of bounds.
That's good for a gain of 16 yards. First down.
So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not. They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So they review it, but there's just not enough evidence to overturn this one. From the 28-yard line, first down. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He's tackled around the 9-yard line.
Number 7 with the tackle at the 9-yard line. That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here.
Here we go.
Move, and he scores. He makes the PAT. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out. I would be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
With the pass, incomplete.
Number 14 was the intended receiver on the play.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 25. Zips it to the back. Tackle made at the 34. He's at midfield. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. Touchdown, Tar Heels. Gives him another touchdown to go along with the one he scored earlier.
The defense has to come out and make a stop on the next drive so this offense can get to work again. They aren't out of this game yet.
To draw within a field goal. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He'll return it from the one. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Kirk, not sure what went on in the locker room at halftime, but both offenses have really come ready to play in this third quarter.
I think that's really what separates a good team from a great team, is being able to make the adjustments at halftime and come out and being able to execute. And so far, we've seen both these offenses able to do that.
So now the offense comes back out, hoping for the same success they had on their last drive.
Great passing was the key for the offense the last time they had the ball. They were able to pick apart the defense and get down the field for a touchdown.
Throws to the tight end, and that ball's incomplete. From their own 20-yard line, second down. Virginia Tech holds a field goal lead. He goes out of bounds at the 24-yard line.
That'll bring up
throws it away, and that'll make it fourth down.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they defended it very well.
And this one is a beauty. They'll bring him down at the 43.
It's early in this game, so the defense can still have an opportunity to make some adjustments. But if things don't turn around in a hurry, it's really going to start to affect the psyche of that defensive line.
Here's the throw, and I don't think he got anything on that. Pressure got to him, and he put it on the ground.
Close one there. Maybe the ball carrier will try a little harder to secure the ball next time.
So the sack makes this third and very long. He's going to go for the home run. Incomplete.
Yeah, the timing here between the quarterback and the receiver looked a little off there. Sometimes that happens, especially on a deep throw.
Brought down at the 37-yard line. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Personal foul. Clipping. Receiving team.
That's frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
From their own 22-yard line, it's first down. Virginia Tech has a three-point lead. He scrambled. And he's tackled at the 26-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
Mike nine. He's on the run. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. And he's taken down around the 46-yard line.
That's good for him.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46. He makes it to the 48-yard line. Strike complete. Tackle right around the 48-yard line. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Scrambling around. It's a fumble. It's picked up.
Once the ball hits the ground, it's a matter of luck and will. And on that play, it was the defensive end who corralled it for his side.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Sack. Great play by the defense.
Ooh, well, that time they came with the blitz and the linebacker was able to get free and come away with the sack.
So the sack makes this a second and long. the 38-yard line. Lets it go.
Nothing clicking there. Let's see if they can make a few adjustments before their next series.
That'll bring up fourth and nine.
And he's taken down at the 29. A fumble really hurt this team's last drive, so let's see if they can make up for that blunder on this drive.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
He's at midfield, catches it, and down he goes around the 39-yard line.
That's a deep 32 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. Virginia Tech is up by three. Decent run here, right side. This has been a fun one if you like offense. The shootout continues as we head to the fourth. 24-21, Virginia Tech. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
There's a player hurt. It doesn't look to be that bad. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 29. Makes the catch and look out, and he tackles him hard at the 15-yard line.
I like this wide receiver a lot. He knows where he needs to be on the field so the quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
Gives it up the gut, and he makes it out to about the 14-yard line. A 1 yard gain by the halfback.
Solid stop there by the corner on that one. I'll tell you, I love to see a cornerback willing to step up and make tackles like that.
From the 14-yard line, second down. Now a man complete, and he's hit hard.
Gain of six on the play. That makes it third and three.
He's got it with room to run. Touchdown, V-Tech. They go to the air and find the fullback for the score.
You don't see that very often. Look at him. He's loving it.
And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 25-yard line. It'll be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Tailback, but he can't bring it in.
Number 15 was the intended receiver on the play.
Third down, 5 yards to go. Ball on their own 30. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. Hit before he could go anywhere.
That was a clutch play on fourth down, but they are still down a couple of scores, and it's going to take some work for this team to get back into this game.
Throws it out there. So they run the same pass play again.
Yeah, typically you'll see this when teams are having success with a particular player. They feel confident about a play's chances.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 46. Down at the 40. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Up the middle for a nice game. That makes it 7-6. Again with the run. He's taken down around the 34-yard line.
Gain of two on the play. Third down.
Fires in there. Got it. Touchdown. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
Here's the extra point to get within a field goal. And he tacks on the extra point. North Carolina ready to kick this one off. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 30. Well, I'm sure the return man would have loved to go for six that time.
Brad, I would anticipate the defense putting 11 defenders up close to the line of scrimmage, doing everything that they can to stop the running game and try to strip that ball away from the running back. An aggressive offense might try to take advantage of that with a play action, fake that run up the middle, and then maybe try to find a tight end, maybe downfield or a wide receiver.
From their own 30-yard line, it's second down. Now he's flushed and they got it.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Just over 2 minutes in the game. They make the stop
at about the 37-yard line.
Well, the defense has done their job and made a nice stand. Now let's see if the special teams can come up with something here as well.
Tackle at the 28-yard line. Well, they've got the ball back, but they're still trailing.
This game is in the offense's hands. I think they have enough time to move the ball down the field and put it in the end zone. I certainly wouldn't want this game heading to overtime if I were on offense right now.
Going long.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second and 10. Ball in the 28. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. He's hit and taken down. They come out in a five-wide set. Gets it out quickly. He's tackled at the 48.
Quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
Spikes the ball. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Fires out to his wideout. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved them back.
Number 18 from the 4 yard line. It's second down. Under a minute left. Tackle made at the one. Touchdown, and they take the lead. The play clock's at double zero. They just took too long.
Delay of game. Offense.
North Carolina is up a field goal. And he hits the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 30-yard line. Virginia Tech. Coaches have got to be confident in the fact that they've got a star player in a tight situation.
And there's nothing better than having a quarterback you have confidence in these kind of situations. You know he's going to make the right read. He's going to give his receivers a chance to make a play on the ball. And they're going to have a really good chance of moving the ball down the field to have a shot to win this game.
Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start. Offense.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
From their own 25-yard line, first down. He's scrambling. He gets sacked on the play. Virginia Tech just took their first timeout. Scrambling. He's out to the 30. Slides down.
Well, they didn't pick up the first down, but he saw that no one was open, so he made the right decision to tuck it and run.
It's third and five. Ball in the 34. Brought down at the 46-yard line. Out and he's going to get sacked. The spike will stop the clock. Well, they've converted one third down play on this drive, but now they're faced with a third and long. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. Well, that's just a huge stop right there here late in the fourth quarter in a game this tight. That might be one we look back on later and say that won the ball game. So this is it right here. One last play and one last chance to win the game. If they can get the Hail Mary, they'll pull out the miracle win. He airs it out. Just an unbelievable stop where they had to have it on fourth down, and that should be the football game. A great game here today in a tight one. North Carolina, 35, Virginia Tech, 31. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.